let 1, comma zeta 2, comma zeta 3 till zeta n be the roots of the equation x raised to n equal to 1 for n greater than or equal to 3. Then the sum 1 upon 2 minus zeta 2 plus 1 upon 2 minus zeta 3 so on till 1 upon 2 minus zeta n equals 2. And we have 4 different options with us. Now to solve this problem, we are going to consider a particular case of n, that is 3. And before we proceed, we need to ensure that none of these 4 options gives identical value with the other options. So let's start with option A. In option A, if I substitute n equal to 3, then I'm going to get 1 plus 1 into 8 divided by 7. So that is 8 by 7. In option B, if we substitute n equal to 3, then the denominator is 7. And now the numerator is 1 plus 3 into 4 minus 8. So it will be 12 minus 8 plus 1, so that is 5 by 7. If we substitute n equal to 3 in the third option, then we will get 1 plus 3 into 2 raised to 2 is 4 minus 8 upon 2 raised to n minus 1 is 4, 4 plus 1, 5. So this is 1. And for option D, we have the value as, okay, the denominator is same as the option C, so 5, and the numerator is now 1 plus 2 times 8 minus 4. So it will be 16 minus 4, 12 plus 1, 13 by 5. So now you can see that none of these 4 options is actually equal to the other. So the case n equal to 3 will produce the right answer and the option. Okay. So let's start with the equation x cube minus 1 equal to 0, where n is 3. And you might be knowing that the complex cube roots of unity or the number 1 are 1, e to the power I 2 pi by 3, and e to the power I 4 pi by 3. So I am using the complex exponential form of the roots, but you can even use the cos theta plus I sin theta 1, which is e to the power I theta. This is the Euler's identity, but the exponential form is sometimes more convenient than the trigonometric form. Okay. Now you also might be knowing that the sum of all complex cube roots of unity is 0. So we'll find it useful here. Okay. So let's now go to the expression which we want to evaluate. It is 1 upon 2 minus zeta 2 plus 1 upon 2 minus zeta 3. And since n is 3, this will be the last term. Okay. So we now have 1 upon 2 minus zeta 2 plus 1 upon 2 minus zeta 3 equal to, it is 2 minus zeta 3 plus 2 minus zeta 2 divided by 4 minus 2 zeta 3 minus 2 zeta 2 plus zeta 2 into zeta 3. On simplification, this gives us 4 minus bracket zeta 2 plus zeta 3 divided by 4 minus 2 into bracket zeta 2 plus zeta 3 plus zeta 2 into zeta 3. Okay. And now we will use this fact that the sum of the complex roots is 0. Now if the sum is 0, then this sum here, zeta 2 plus zeta 3, must be equal to minus 1. So let's substitute this sum as minus 1. The numerator will be 4 minus minus 1 or 4 plus 1. And the denominator will now be equal to 4 minus 2 into minus 1 plus the product of the other two roots. Now if we multiply e raised to I 2 pi by 3 and e raised to I 2 pi by 3, then we will get e to the power I 6 pi by 3, which is e to the power I 2 pi, and that is cos 2 pi plus I sin 2 pi, which is 1. So the last term is 1. So now we have 5 upon 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is 5 upon 7. So the expression for n equal to 3 evaluates to 5 by 7. And now let's go back to the options and check. The correct option is option B because it gives us the value 5 by 7. And hence option B.